Supernovae are the most powerful explosions in the universe. A star suddenly appears and vanishes has been a great mystery throughout human history. Today, with the help of space telescopes and a stroke of luck, we finally get to witness the epic ending of a star's life. On May 19, 2023, such an event occurred in the galaxy named Messier 101. It was the brightest supernova observed in the past decade. I couldn't miss this chance as an astrophotographer. M101 is located near the handle of the Big Dipper. The distance between us is 21 million light years. Believe or not, compared to others, this galaxy is considered close to us. After one night of exposure, I created this wide field image of M101. It's a grand design spiral galaxy with a diameter twice of our Milky Way. It's hard to imagine there are trillion stars in this small pinwheel. This is the supernova 2023 IXF. If we gradually darken the image, it's clear how bright it was. It's even brighter than the galactic core, which contains billions of stars. Last month, I took another image of the supernova. In less than a year, its luminosity has faded. In the next few months, it could become invisible to my telescope. But a supernova is not just a star exploding and disappearing. The oxygen we breathe, the iron in our blood, and even the silicon that forms the rock of our planet were all created by supernovae billions of years ago. Additionally, most supernovae leave behind a neutron star or collapse into a black hole. Today we see many supernova remnants in our galaxy, such as the Crab Nebula and the Veil Nebula. Those explosions happened hundreds or thousands of years ago. And for some reason, there hasn't been a supernova in our galaxy for 400 years. Return to the recent supernova in M101. Well, I don't expect my small telescope to capture details of a supernova millions of light years away. What about our most advanced space telescopes? This image was captured by the James Webb Space Telescope 1 month after the explosion. Even with JWST's resolution, the supernova appears a mere dot of light. To see the details of the supernova from such a distance is equivalent to see the texture on a grain of sand from 40 miles away. To achieve that resolution in visible light, we will need a space telescope with mirror at least 27 meters in diameter. However, humanity is fortunate. There was one supernova that exploded in 1987, right in front of our cosmic doorsteps. Supernova 1987A is located in the Large Magellanic Cloud, a small satellite galaxy of Milky Way, visible from the southern hemisphere. The distance between us is 168,000 light years. 100 times closer compared to the supernova in M101. Although it's the closest supernova in 400 years, it's still incredibly small. The diameter of this ring is only 1.4 arcseconds, 1,000 times smaller than the full moon. But that's big enough for the modern telescopes. This image captured by the Hubble Space Telescope reveals something we never saw before. Two outer rings and one inner ring, with a structure like a keyhole at the center. As the nearest supernova in modern times, it has been the most intensely studied object in the sky. Countless images have been taken, and thousands of papers have been published about this supernova. So this is a simple version of what we think happened. Hundreds of thousands of years ago, a blue supergiant star, 16 times more massive and 100,000 times brighter than the Sun, started its final journey. Over the previous millions of years, it has used up its hydrogen in the core, starting to burn helium. For the next 100,000 years, the core burned hotter and faster. Helium fused into carbon, while the outer layer started to swell and blow away, forming the rings we see today. and then things escalated quickly. Carbon burned to neon in 1,000 years, neon burned to oxygen in 1 year, oxygen to silicon in 1 month, silicon to iron in 1 day. Finally, 1 day, 168,000 years ago, the most incredible thing happened. Iron doesn't release energy and fuels together. The immense gravity takes control. The core of the star, a 5,000-kilometer iron ball with 1.4 solar masses, squeezed to the size of Manhattan in less than 1 second. Electrons and protons fuse into neutrons, releasing energy 100 times as our sun produced over its entire life. At the same time, along with the core, the whole star collapsed, holding with 25% speed of light, then bounced off the neutron core, expelling everything into space, leaving the core we call the neutron star. This is the core collapsing supernova we saw on February 23rd, 1987. Since the explosion, supernova 1987A has continued to be the target of all kinds of telescopes. This is a time-lapse video from 1994 to 2016 made by Hubble's image. In 2001, 14 years after the supernova, an invisible shockwave traveling at 7,000 kilometers per second caught up and smashed into the ring, making the ring glow across the spectrums. As we speak, the shockwave has destroyed the inner ring and expanding out into space. This image was taken by JWST in 2023. By analyzing the spectrums of the center ejecta, an international team has announced they found evidence of the neutron star, making it the most youngest neutron star we know. The center ejecta, shaped like a keyhole, contains all kinds of heavy elements, with iron alone is worth 20,000 times the mass of Earth. These will disperse into space and become the next generation of stars and planets. Just FYI, don't underestimate the size of this thing. The diameter of the ring is 1.3 light years. This means that one pixel in this image can fit 3 solar systems. In the future, nearby stars like Betelgeuse and Eta Carinae are potential candidates for supernova events. This is a Hubble image of the star SBW-2007, the double ring structure bearing striking similarity to supernova 1987A. Perhaps one of these stars will explode in our lifetime, but for now, supernova 1987A remains our best opportunity to study the phase before, during, and after the demise of a star.